Around the world, over 91 million children under the age of 5 are growing up with debilitating hunger. 134 million children have no access to any school whatsoever. An estimated 1 million children are forced into the commercial sex trade every year. 15 million children are orphaned as a result.
246 million children.
171 million children.
265 million.
Over one third of children.
376 million
children.
Over half.
Over one third of children.
No point
in saving responsible water sources. If today's children are the seeds of tomorrow's church, what kind of future will we reap?
One day some children were brought to Jesus so that he could lay his hands on them and he could bless them. And the disciples told the children not to bother him. Even the disciples of Jesus didn't get it. They didn't understand the importance of children. It's such an easy trap for us to fall into, and it's one of Satan's most powerful lies.
Let the children come to me. Don't stop them, for the kingdom of heaven belongs to such as these.
To Jesus, children matter. And not only do they matter, they give us a little glimpse of heaven. If you want to know what heaven looks like, look at a child.
Through Christ's eyes, children are an example of what God wants from each of us. Humility, lowliness of heart and mind, a teachable spirit, the kind of simple faith that wouldn't have walked tentatively on the water as Peter did, but would have skipped and frolicked. Perhaps that's why the enemy delights in the suffering of children.
The enemy knows how impressionable children are, and he knows that what they experience now will not only echo through the rest of their lives, but for generations to come.
Poverty is one of the most destructive forces facing children today.
Poverty steals from children the one thing God has blessed them with so much of, hope.
37% of the world's children live in absolute poverty. That's over 674 million children. Almost two times the population of the entire United States.
There's a terrible misconception that poverty is just a lack of food and clothing. It's so much more.
Poverty is a lack of opportunity, a lack of vital child development, and at its core, a lack of options.
Today's children of poverty will become tomorrow's parents of poverty unless we speak up for them and reach into their lives while the clay is still soft.
Poverty and the lack of proper child development are not the only obstacles. There is another threat, one that impacts children in unimaginable ways. Not long ago, a young Ethiopian girl named Silamowit lost her mother to AIDS. And on that day, she became more than an orphan.
I am like his sister and his mother, and he is like my brother and my father.
Every day, there are 14,000 people who become infected with the virus that causes AIDS. That's not a faceless statistic. These are real mothers and fathers, somebody's sister, somebody's brother, families that get just ripped apart by this destructive disease.
As if it isn't hard enough to cope with the loss of parents, these children are also faced with the additional burden that few are willing to take them in. The stigma of HIV/AIDS makes them outcasts.
They've already been dealt one terrible blow, living in poverty. But when it's combined with HIV/AIDS, the urgency to speak up on behalf of children becomes overwhelming.
Speaking up for children is more than just the right thing to do. It is what God commands us to do.
Jesus wasn't saying, "Oh, look how sweet those children are. Let them come to me." He was saying to the disciples that were trying to dismiss them, "Stop doing that. Stop hindering them. Let the children come to me."
Yet with all God teaches us about children, we're still somehow missing the point. Even though 85% of Christians come to Christ between the ages of 4 and 14, the average church only focuses about 15% of its resources on ministering to children.
Satan doesn't want us to remember the power that God has given children. Psalm 8 tells us that children have been created to praise God. And not only that, but that they have the power to silence the foe and silence the enemy. To make a difference in the lives of children, all we have to do is to find our voice and speak up for those who can't speak for themselves.
The moment I made a commitment to become an advocate for children, God showed me where He could use me.
I started educating my church about the needs of HIV/AIDS orphans in Africa.
I became a mentor to a disadvantaged child.
I sponsor a child living in extreme poverty in El Salvador.
Jesus calls us to reach out to them, to love them, to speak up for them, to offer them hope and a place in the kingdom.
The kingdom belongs.
The kingdom of heaven.
The kingdom belongs.
The church says
God has a place for
God
me.
God has a place for me.
I am precious.
I am precious.
I am precious in His sight.
Find your voice and start speaking up for God's children today. Change the life of a child and the course of the church. To learn how, visit compassion.com.
What you do to them, you are doing to me.